So, I just got my microphone in. And now, I gotta figure out what I'm gonna record. What I'm gonna record is gonna be different. I gotta figure out how I'm gonna record it. I gotta figure out which microphone I'm gonna use. If I'm gonna use this microphone right here, or if I'm gonna use my other Rode microphone. And then I have to switch it over to the actual microphone, which is this one right here, and just make it work that way. But I am hyped. So hyped. Got my trusty knife, and we're gonna get to work. Don't mind the mess in the background. It's pretty normal at this point. Throw it up to the fishes. Yes, they're still alive. I know the last time we talked, one died, but that was bad long ago. So, yeah, that's where I'm at right now. Say what up to Magic. Moose. My picture of Magic and Moose. And that's me. So, let's get to it. All right, so I don't know if you guys can fully see me. This is the most flattering angle, but I gotta work with what I gotta work with. So, what if, can I? Let's see if I could professionalize this up a little. I think I was able to. Yo. All right, so thank you to whoever got me this knife. Just cut all the wires off. I don't really need this knife, but I just like, every time I see a YouTuber, I always got some kind of cool knife. Ooh. Oh, reveal. I got the blue one. That's why my room's always a mess. So I got this blue one. You know what? I was a little skeptical about this one. Little, very tad. So, let's see. I got the NT1 Signature Series. And this comes with an XLR cable, 10-year warranty. And I do need phantom power. That's what I was mentioning earlier in the pod before. And a shock mount. I'm a little slow. Grab more goddamn tape. You just hurt daddy. That's what you're doing. Register for your 10 years. That's what I gotta do. So I'm gonna register this before I do anything else. So, pretty sure this is the mic. So, my bad, guys. I'm not the fastest. There goes the pouch. Ooh, that's pretty. That's real pretty. Oh, I'm like, why is it making that noise? All right, what is this bad boy? The XLR cable. Did they send me a blue one? No, they sent me a black one. Ooh. Do 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 do. there goes the pop filter. All right, you see this? I like this. So I have another pop filter. I have mad recording equipment. So like, you see how it says Rode there? I was trying to figure out if I should make my own version of it that I can do, just paint it. But I don't know how it's gonna affect the pop filter, but I'm currently working on something for that. Put this over here. And here comes the bad boy. Look at this behemoth. This joint is huge, bruh. She got some weight to her, which is gonna make me wonder how I'm gonna do all of this. What is this for? What does this go to? Microphone goes here. This is probably gonna go here. It's probably gonna dangle a little. But yeah, I'm very hype to show you the pieces of the Rode NT1. Now, I'm gonna change it up a bit. I'm gonna set it up so you can see how it's gonna record. So, I'll be back. All right, guys, so welcome back to another microphone review with me. I ended up getting this bad boy, the Rode Signature NT1. So far, I haven't really got to play with it, so this is my first time really recording footage for it. I just did an unboxing, if you didn't see. And if you're wondering, the microphone that I'm using right now, I am using the Rode Pod Mic, which they say is the most superior pod microphone for Rode right now. Well, I don't think it's this one. I think it's the one above it, the one with the USB, but I don't really need a USB charge. The Rode Podcast Mic is good too. I was considering getting that. And then there's this one, the NT1 Signature. And this is basically the new fifth generation one, but less froze. Like, people make the extra USB port like really a big thing. So I just wanted to go through the motions with you guys of you guys telling me which one's a better microphone. Can you really hear the differences? Aesthetically, the blue looks cool with the pink wire. I didn't know that was gonna be happening. And it also matches my hat. So, pretty cool stuff. I didn't plan this. Now, I just noticed. All right, so the biggest con that I had, or the con that everybody had with this microphone that I'm holding in my hand, the Rode Pod Mic, is that you kind of have to almost damn near max out the volume to get a good sound, right? Even me being on top of the microphone right now, the way I am right now, is a huge difference, right? Now, if I didn't want to max out my microphone, what I did was, I don't know if you can see it, on my right-hand side is a little blue box. That was the cloud lifter. So it amplified the sound and it made it such cool. It was a game changer. That's basically what I'm saying. It was a game changer to add that to the structure of my show. Everybody could tell the difference. Everybody liked the difference and so on and so forth. So when I switched over to the NT1 Signature Series, I wanted to see, my bad, this wire is like rubbing everywhere, mad annoying. So when I switched over to the N1 Signature Series, I wanted to see how it would work with the cloud lifter. But in true fashion, if you know anything about my show, which is, well, that one too, but it's really this one, you would know that I don't fact check anything, and that your boy just randomly, impulsively buys things, which is why I am in so much debt now. But you're not here for this. You're here to find out how this Rode NT1 Signature sounds compared to the Pod Mic. And this is a cheat code. What is that noise in the background? That's the
Hey, so let's see if that actually stays in. But to be honest, I don't think this caught as much as this one did, but I won't know until I'm doing an edit. So if you guys are interested in the Rode NT1 Signature series, and you just got like a side-by-side comparison, and I don't know how good your ear is to see if you can really hear the difference, but yeah. Let me know in the comment section.
I want to do an edit somebody's car with this video. Well, this song with the Stewie Griffin in the background. So today's a really late start. I should have been at work, but haven't been able to sleep lately, but you're not here for that. Now, I used the Rode NT1. I used the Rode NT1 for the first time yesterday. I set it up. I got it yesterday. I just dropped a video on YouTube this morning. So after you guys watch this, if you guys didn't see it yet, you can go back to second to last video and you guys can see it. Yeah, my nigga, what's up? So the biggest difficulty I had with that microphone wasn't setting it up. It wasn't even trying to like configure it, because I use a Rode. I just noticed I use mad Rode products, so I'm gonna need Rode to like look into me, because I have mad of your microphones, a bunch of your microphones, and help a brother out. Y'all stuff ain't cheap. But back to what I was saying, the biggest issue I had with the microphone wasn't the actual microphone use. It sounds amazing. I was able to like play with some instruments while recording. Well, instrument, you hear my dumb ass? And it was just a cool mic. It's just that the whole setup is heavy. It can't go on a regular stand because of the way it's built. Unless I could find like an attachment piece that turns it into like a regular piece for me to set up, which I gotta look into, because I was having difficulties trying to find a place to mount it. And I didn't know, I was looking for a whole adapter piece, but it had the adapter piece built into it. I just wasn't paying attention. So it had like a 5/8 adapter and a 1/4 adapter. So my microphone setup that I normally use is for a 1/4 adapter. That's what the Rode Pod mic uses. So I was like, okay. So I started thinking, I'm like, all right, I used the Gator stand and I'm like, it's too heavy. My joint was leaning like this. I was like, I'm gonna knock it down. And yesterday the mic did fall when I did set up into the microphone stand that I did end up using it, because the desk stands are cool, but the minute you off center it falls down, like it tips over like a fucking, like a sheep or a goat, whichever one's, I think it's a ghost that you scare him and it just, but it was just trying to figure out a setup and then finding the right microphone position, which I'm still not thrilled with, but I'll figure it out. I can make it work. It's just me adjusting the camera, really. But other than that, that joint did exactly what I needed it to do. That shit sounded amazing. I brought it back to the regular preset. I didn't need a cloud lifter. It seems like it filtered out a lot of the noise, because like the most funniest shit is that I don't know what it is, but when men get older, they just start making all these random noises, bro. Like, my dad just makes random noises when he just, like, brushes his teeth. It sounds like he's trying to, like, strangle himself. So I'm in the middle of recording, and I hear, I'm like, what the fuck is that? And it's my dad in the background. I'm like, this nigga's brushing his teeth. This nigga. But, it was, like, the most funniest shit. But because of the cloud lifter made everything so much sensitive. So when I say, like, the cloud lifter, like, regular microphone, it'll pick up the shit in the house. Like, this microphone picks up everything around the house. So I thank God for the processor and the noiser and the noise gate, all that shit. And it's like, all right, it takes it away. So a lot of times you guys are hearing me complain, like, what the fuck is that noise? You guys would never hear it because the processor took care of it. But, yeah. This one did good. I like it. I just want to find a better mic stand situation. And then that'll be the end of that. I don't want to spend money. I don't want to spend money. It's not that I don't want to spend money. I don't have to spend money. Because when I say I have a whole closet, a whole arsenal full of things for me to use. Like my microphones, that microphone could break. The next microphone could break. Oh, the cool shit about it, it has a 10-year warranty. Unheard of. But as I was saying, that microphone could break. The pod mic could break. And I still have three Audio Technias, to be honest. All right. Those could break. I still have two Sterlings. I'm like, I have a shitload of microphones, bro. So it's like, I'm not worried, and they all sound good. The Sterling sounds a little echoey, but I'm pretty sure I could fix that. That's what I originally started shooting with. That's the original pod mic. But, yeah, it was fun. It was fun using it. I can't wait to record my first show with it. And, right now, I'm thinking about the next episode and if I want to use a new format. Because, just to try it out, because I mentioned before that I want to start changing segments of the show. I want to see what else I could put in there. Because in order for me to give people what they want, which is 2 episodes, which is 2 episodes a week. I can't do that right now. Like, this shit's kicking my ass. And the only reason you guys get a second episode of me out of the week, which is the vlog, is because I'm able to attach this to my car and drive and go. It doesn't sound the best audio because you get all this background noise. But, yeah. That's what I'm trying to do. This was my best answer for people that wanted 2 episodes. Okay, like this is more like in my life, this is more random. This is me just really just going off, like just talking. And I think this is way more personal. And I think that's the other thing. See, I was having this conversation about podcasts, and I was like, the Joe Rogan podcast is cool, right? It's cool, entertaining, informative. Every now and then there's a hot take. Do I agree with some of his stance? Not really, but it's a great show. And I always say the second runner up is the JBP, and it's only because he gets personal. He talks about his life, and you guys see my show, I talk about my life too. And that's what opened up the door for me, really, because it's just me just, all right, let me just let you in a little, let me give you a peek of why I am the way I am, how I act, the reason I act the way I act and shit like that. So it's like, all right. And like, it's insightful. Like, I lived a lot of life. That sounds mad cliche. But there's also a lot I can't talk about. Probably like until like a couple more years to the statutes of limitations and stuff. But there's like a lot. Not like I'm gonna be like dry snitching. Oh yeah, this year this happened. No, it's like, it's just a lot of shit that I would love to talk about, like situations I got myself into, and without incriminating myself. But yeah. But that's like the most funniest shit. You know who also does that? It's $1 million worth of game, which is Wallo. Wallo always does that. Wallo talks about being in prison, like the shit that he's went through. And the shit he's trying to change and the things he's trying to do for people. And it's like, that's dope. Because I think Wallo did like 20 years. And like he'll check somebody every now and then. Because I know there's people that watch my show sometimes. And they'll be like, I don't think that happened. And it's like, no, I have somebody that could fucking clarify. Or like, I must be misremembering something. And like,
they would be like, somebody would be like, no, that's not how it happened, which is funny, but you guys will never get to see it. But on that show, Wallow be like fucking up Gilly, because he'd be like, I used to be cold back in the day. Like, when I used to walk outside, everybody would go in. I'd go to the corner, everybody clear the corner. And he was like, where the fuck was I at? Because every time me and you were there, we were chilling. We were having the best conversations of our lives. So it was like, it's pretty fucking funny. And it's like, it be like that sometimes. Because I have friends that I talk to from back in the day, and they misremember shit. They misremember a lot of shit. And it's like, I don't think it really played out like that. Like one time there was a fight that broke out. A fight broke out. A fight broke out, right? There was after him. So I'm like, I got you. I'm stupid. I'm naive. I'm fucking loyal like a dumbass. And I go, yo, son, whatever. Like, we got this. Me and you versus all 30 of them. Let's fucking go. So, in his story, he was like, yeah, I was fucking them up. Left and right. Left and right. Left and right. Tossing motherfuckers. They wasn't ready. All that shit. And I'm like, no, sir. I was getting busy. You were stuck with your one person the whole fucking time. It was like a scene of Rush Hour when Carter's fighting one guy and Jackie Chan's fighting everybody. I was like, they were trying to beat the dog shit out of me for fucking defending you. So, yeah, man. As I mentioned before, I want to do different segments. I want to do different episodes and just chill like that. I would like to do interviews. I'm not big enough to do celebrity interviews, so I'm gonna keep it local. And just work something out from there. I would love to do on the street interviews. I ain't got time for that. And then the market was oversaturated. Shout out to Super Duper Humble, because he was doing what I wanted to do. And I was like, that's exactly where PTL was going. It was going right there. So shout out to him. Get better, man. He's sick right now. He got ended up catching SJS. SJS is fucking crazy, bro. SJS is just your body's allergic to medication and just decides to fucking try to shut down in the most excruciating way, bro. His whole skin, he started getting blisters, bumps all over his skin. His face looked like he got stung like by like 1,000 bees. And then his skin started falling off. Like I saw the video where they were peeling like notebook size sections of his skin off so it could heal. That shit was crazy, bro. So yeah, that's, damn, there's mad traffic. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm trying to figure out, trying to revamp. And not that the formula is not working. It's just every now and then you try to do something different. Try to see what something else would look like. And you can't blame, yo, come on, we're not gonna let everybody fucking in, right? You can't blame me for trying to like bring different things into like the light. Cause hear me out was never a thing. Cool Report's been a thing. Part-time Lover's never been a thing. Part-time Lover was an idea that I just said, fuck it, I just brought to life. Part-time Lover was gonna come, but it wasn't gonna be Part-time Lover under the same guise. Part-time Lover was gonna, when we were all together, we were talking about everybody should have their own segments. I always had Part-time Lover and the Cool Report. I was like, I have those two segments, I can always run with those. And, what the fuck is that? Where is that shit at? It's driving traffic. Driving traffic. Okay. So why the fuck are the idiots in the left slowing down? It's on the right. People are dumb, bro. People people are so dumb. That shit annoys me. Everybody's gonna try to cut left. It's moving traffic. He's not at his destination yet. It's on the right lane. Everybody in the left lane slowing down like fucking idiots. People in the middle lane makes sense because everybody's cutting into your lane, but everybody in the left lane should not be slowing down. What I should do, I want to record my drive. I want to get an action camera, but not for action, just for me to give you a live traffic report, like on Facebook or some shit. Like on the Northern State Parkway, three fucking idiots are in front of me not doing shit, so I'm gonna go this way. I don't know, every time I try to do like a newscaster, a broadcaster voice, that shit sounds mad left. Like, it's like, I sound like a robot and we're going down the expressway at 45 knots per kilometer seconds. But yeah. Alright, man, that's what I wanted to talk about. Microphone is cool. I can't wait to fuck around with it. Use it for other than podcasting. And this is a microphone I feel like I could probably rent out to like a studio, because it's meant for singing. It's meant for music. It's meant for all these things. I don't know. There was a microphone that they said, maybe it might have been my pod mic. So they were saying that it's not great for voice work, which I wouldn't get, but that's not my field. I can't talk about a field I don't know nothing about. So, pretty interesting. All right, I'll be back.
Six magazines that's aimed at me, done every magazine was fame to me, it's a game to me, it's a fair romance. Sleep, I ain't never had a fast with that. What's fair when the hearts and the words don't reach? What's fair when the money don't take these back? It's rare when somebody take your dreams back. I care too much, wanna share too much, I hear too much, I shut down too, I ain't there too much, I'm a complex soul that
never be. So I just got some lunch. I almost walked out of work today, man. I don't be in the mood for the guys to be playing in there. So got some food. There's a spot out here that's like Chinese selfie spot, so I could get like an egg roll and some horchata. Turn it right now, it just stops. Like I could get a chicharrón, egg roll. Chinese food and Spanish food kind of go hand in hand. Like a lo mein pupusa, that might be different. Or an egg roll pupusa, which would just probably just be a fucking cheese egg roll. Cause they already make egg rolls. Yeah, fuck you. What would be a cool fusion? Because when the Chinese and Americans got together, let me do March out there. When the Chinese and Americans got together, right? They didn't hit it out the park, man. They kind of got like they made a corn dog. That wasn't really like a. It's just a fucking hot dog that's an egg roll. But I'm trying to think, what's an interesting fusion of food to be mixed? Because when I went to Cats was cool. It was a cool fusion, but it was like not really the most daring of combinations. Like mac and cheese and jerk chicken. Well, those things are going to go good together no matter what. Like a hot dog taco? That's the same as a corn dog. You already have the torta as a hamburger. Well, America's got bison burgers, ostrich burgers, and all these things. I never had an ostrich burger. I had a bison burger. That shit was delicious. I think I recorded myself eating that on the third vlog. What can? Because I know in Jersey there's like an Indian ice cream store out there, right? Which makes like spaghetti ice cream, which is weird. Like not like they shape the ice cream into spaghetti, but they dead ass add spaghetti to the ice cream. And Samantha sent me something in my neighborhood that I pass by all the time called Chickies. And I'm like, no. Chickies ain't the one, all right? It's good food probably, but I'm more interested in the store that's next to it called Curry on Pizza. Now that's, there you go right there. That's an interesting combination. Do I want to try it? Fuck no. I'm not really a fan of curry like that. But that's thinking outside the box. Curry pizza. I'm more interested in that one than Chickies. Even though Chickies food looks delicious, but if I want to like tickle my senses, pause. Curry on pizza. I have to be really daring one day and bored with life. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to get some curry pizza. You guys are like, that's not the worst thing. You ever had salad on the pizza? Yeah, that's just a salad, my nigga, with cheese on it. That's no different than a Caesar salad without the dressing. Some of y'all really thought y'all hit it out the park with that one. Like, oh my god, a salad that's a pizza. Ooh, I'm being bad, but good at the same time. No, you're still being bad. It's still a lot of carbs. You're just basically eating a salad on a big-ass crouton. I want to carry this conversation a little bit more when I really get my mind to go. That's corny. It's an excessive amount of corn. Niggas is savage.
Niggas is monsters. Niggas is pimps. Niggas is players.
Niggas have daughters.
Now they were conscious, so I don't forget me. I'm scared of the karma, cause now I see women as something.
My bad, I'm trying to get past this intersection without being hit.
I hope she like Nikki, I make her a monster. I have the menages. I'm just being silly, I answer the door like what's Smith and Martin.
Nigga, do we have a problem?
They send me the Farkas. I beat his ass, pray I beat the charges. No daddy don't play, not when it comes to their daughters. Don't do no yoga, don't do Pilates. Just play piano, we'll stick to karate. I pray your bodies, play more like mine and not like your mommy's. Just being salty, but niggas is nuts.
Ooh, somebody just got a ticket. I'll be back.
I pray that you don't get it.
I'm at the Queens Botanical Gardens. Light show. No pictures.
What happened?
Your visitor or security?
Visitor.
Huh?
Visitor.
Visitor, okay.
IHOP things. I'm recording. Can you not interrupt me? Can you not interrupt me? Can you not even look at me? Alright. Okay, Yokozuna. Alright, relax. Relax. They can hear you turning the pages, ignoring me. Stop slapping. Stop smiling. What's wrong with you? Huh? You think this is a game? You think I'm over here having fun with you? You're ruining my content. My viewers don't like this. Fuck it. I'm gonna get some pancakes, this loser. Alright. I'll be back. Rich. You're rich, okay? Alright, guys. Which one's better, this way? Or this way? Childish. Churlish. So you guys should go look.
Did you have any issues?
No. I'm an adult. Shout out to my Thea. Got some ketchup. Just a dash. I'm gonna enjoy my food, all right, guys? So, I am on a swing. And I just want to show you guys one of my frivolous purchases. Wait, I did this wrong. I did this wrong. That's so embarrassing. Guys, I'm not this much of a loser. I still did it wrong. Oh, I can never be as cool as those guys from Harlem. But got myself a shiesty. Before they ban it out here in New York, I feel like I shouldn't really take pictures with this because this would kind of make like the surveillance easier. Like if I get picked out of a lineup, they could probably use this blog as something to use against me. I feel like this is still wrong. See something. I'm fucking with my eye holes. Next time I'll do nothing for none of you. Ooh, I think it really brings out the felony in my eyes. Well, guys, this is the end of this vlog. Thank you for watching. Please continue to like, comment, share, subscribe. And until next week, in my next felony, I am out. Peace.
Saw a woman psychiatrist. And she said I was OCD, one cool dude. And she understands the way I think right now. And everything's cool.
Which is why I am in so much debt now. But you're not here for this. You're here to find out how this Rode NT1 signature sounds compared to the pod mic. And this is a cheat code. Only because I'm using a Rode Procaster to like really... The fuck is that?